Good afternoon, I'm here to introduce you to the Brother Twin Needle, which is needle feed. Not like a walking foot which walks over the fabric, the needle actually enters the fabric and pulls the fabric forward. So it literally doesn't go just down, it goes forward and claws its way into the fabric, which means you can do heavier weight fabrics and you can also do lighter weight fabrics without having so much pressure on the foot and the dog teeth from underneath. So basically I'm just going to show you one of the special things about this is not just a needle feed, it's a needle feed with a knockout, which means you can switch off one of the needles. So if you've got a back of a pair of jeans, you've got the back pocket, you can literally get it to stop as it goes around the corner. So you can get it to stop on that corner and continue. So it runs in parallel, but also you can get it to stop, start. So I'm just going to run a little bit here. This is a bit of denim, this is two sides, just a trouser leg. And basically got the foot lift at the back, and you've got one just like a normal machine. It's a beautiful machine to work with. It requires two bobbins. Got the back stitch here. This is absolutely beautiful. Look, you can just go round. And if I try and slow it down a bit, you can actually see the motion of the needle coming forward as opposed to just going down. So I'm going to just run that off. I'm using quite a thick thread on this. I'm going to pull that off and I'm going to move it a bit together just to show you what this machine can do. So this is some really thick leather, nice and tan, a good weight. So just lift the foot, in we go. Not a problem. And then I'm going to go to the corner and I'm going to try to do the knockout. So I want the right off. Oh, I'm not sure what I've done there. So the right needle stayed up. I actually want the left needle to stay up. I want to go around the corner. I do believe. So you press that and it resets it. I've come to the end of the fabric. I'm just going to reverse and go back to both needles. And I'm just going to go reverse. Not a problem. Okay, so I'm going to just come away from there. Look over to the left needle. And I'm going to turn that corner. And you should see that there is no stitch across that line. And then I can switch the needle back on again by pressing the reset button. And you'll see that it's actually stopped there. And I'll just do that again one more time, just to demonstrate. So left, I'm a bit rusty, but it's pretty easy to go, easy going. So I'm just going to go there. But the thing is I keep on forgetting to switch it back on, so I'm going to try that again. I'm going to go the other direction this time. Well, both my things are up. Okay, so right. Both up. One needle. Two needles. Okay, I'm going to try and get it right now. I haven't used this machine for, I'm not sure how long, I wouldn't like to say, but right, down, I'm going to just fold that back, turn, just take a certain amount of concentration, and then I'm going to go two stitches forward, without that one, I'm going to bring that one back in now. Successfully turned the corner there and I've run parallel. That makes sense. A beautiful machine, very easy to use. We have manuals pretty similar to a straight stitch, except you have two bobbins and two needles, and you basically, if you've got your two needles like that, when you thread up, you thread that way and that way. So it's quite similar to a conventional straight straight stitch brother machine. The threading up slightly more complicated, but not anything that you need to worry about. Thanks for watching.